Now let's continue and create some rafters to support the roof. Display the ground floor by double-clicking its name in the project map of the pop-up navigator or at the tab bar. Activate the section tool in the toolbox. Draw a section line vertically in the middle of the building. Click with the eye cursor to the left of the section line. Please note that the section will automatically appear in the section list of the pop-up navigator. Double-click on the new section item in the navigator to open it. Please notice that the walls intersect with the roof. You may zoom in to the wall-roof intersection to have a closer look at it. To solve this, we have to change the priority of a roof skin. Select the roof and open the Building Materials dialog using the Options, Element Attributes menu option. Select the airspace frame from the list on the left. Set the intersection priority of this airspace to 735 in order to make it higher than the building materials of the wall composite. The airspace is located at the bottom layer of the roof composite. Click OK to apply the changes. Please notice that the wall-roof connection is now correct. You'll take advantage of the automatic surface recognition when placing the first rafter. Switch to the 3D window. Select the roof and open its settings. Display the model panel of the Roof Selection Settings dialog. Turn off Surface Override for the edge surfaces of the roof. Click OK. The skins of the roof are now visible. Activate the Beam tool in the toolbox and open its Settings dialog. Display the Geometry and Positioning panel. Enter 0.2 meters for beam height, as well as for the beam width. Select the rectangular structure. Select the timber structural building material. Select the inclined option and enter 18 degrees for the beam inclination value. Enter 0.1 for the reference axis offset value. We have not set the elevation of the beam because we'll use automatic surface recognition to determine the elevation automatically. Display the floor plan and section panel. Select Home Story only for show on stories. Select Projected with Overhead for floor plan display. And select Entire Element for show projection. Scroll down and uncheck the Show Reference Axis option. Display the Categories and Properties panel. Select Load-Bearing Element for Structural Function. Select Exterior for Position. And select Beam for Element Classification. Make sure that the structural bearing layer is selected. Click OK to apply all changes. Use the Zoom and Orbit commands to navigate in the 3D view as presented on the screen. Select the Single Geometry method in the info box. Zoom into the lower edge of the roof. We will place the beam along the top plane of the airspace skin of the roof. Click the top of the airspace skin at the lower edge of the roof. Zoom out, and then zoom in to the upper edge of the roof. Now, click the upper edge of the airspace skin again. Notice that the first rafter, using the beam tool, is now placed. Select the roof and open its settings dialog. Display the model panel and turn on Surface Override again for the roof edges. Click OK to apply this change. Open the gallery plan from the project map of the pop-up navigator or simply from the tab bar. Select the rafter created earlier. Activate the Multiply command from the context menu, or you can also use the shortcut Ctrl plus U to activate this option. In the Multiply dialog, select the Drag and Distribute actions and enter 12 for the number of copies. Click OK to continue. Click the top left corner of the rafter. Hold down the Shift key to constrain mouse movement horizontally. And click the top left corner of the roof to create 12 additional rafters. Click elsewhere on the empty screen or press Escape once to deselect the newly created rafters. Open the 3D window to see the result. Use the Orbit and Explore commands to navigate in the 3D view to check the results. You may also check the results in the section view as well.